What's the ratio for all three of you in terms of on campus versus commuter? Because that could be a big part of the expense too nowadays if kids are able to stay home or be in their own hometown and go to Maryville or Fontbonne or Columbia. What's your percentage
Well,
of?
we have 20, we'll top out at about 2,100 traditional undergraduates at Maryville, and our overall enrollment is going to be about 6,400 students. Of those 2,100, a little over 700 are residential, and the rest are commuters.
At Fontbonne, we're largely commuter. We have about 280 students on campus out of about 2,000. Our mission has always been largely to serve the greater St. Louis area, and we continue to do that.
And Columbia College is going to be a longer answer because
We've got time.
we're a little different. We were founded in 1851 as a residential college, in that case a women's college, as we mentioned. We still have that. We have a fantastic college. Classes just started this week, and we have soccer teams and volleyball teams and all sorts of great things going on. It's just what you would envision probably. But we also have about more than 25,000 other students in other venues across the United States. We have 35 additional locations in 13 states and in Cuba. And we have many, many online students. We have had a very large online program since the year 2000, and we've built on that base. So we are everywhere, literally from San Diego to New York, from Florida and Cuba to Seattle, and all sorts of places in between. So we have a very large adult serving operation in addition to our residential campus, which is under 1,000 students.
Did you mention? Yeah, go ahead.
No, that's just, so not the same numbers, but similar for us. We have an online population of about 2,700 students in 50 states across the country, and then other adult students on ground here in St. Louis. So similar to that, we've got, and that's really the fastest growing market in education, quite frankly, is the adult market. Over the next 20 years, that market is just expanding by leaps and bounds because almost everyone who gets a degree, and Randy won't like it when I say this, your daughter, when she gets her degree, in all likelihood, will have to go
I'm
back
glad
to
you said
school.
when and not
Well, like you said, but we'll likely go back to school.
We'll have to go
And
back either
some
for
type of training.
either a certificate, some kind of training, a degree, or an advanced degree. Because of the nature of the global economy, the nature of professions changing and rapidly evolving and devolving and developing again, everybody's going to have to come back to school. That's the huge market in education going forward.